Good morning students. Last class we discussed about elements can be divided into four blocks. So there are four blocks, is there S, P, D, F blocks. So today we discuss about periodicity and what happens valency electrons, valency number of cells in the group and period. So here periodicity. So what is the meaning of periodicity?
Periodicity.
The properties of elements can be repeated after time interval is called as a periodicity. The properties of elements can be repeated after time interval. Is called periodicity. So this is definition. Next, we discuss about number of cells. So here, what happens? Number of cells top to bottom in a group, from left to right in a period. So here we consider as outermost cell but not inner cells. So number of cells we can identify. So here number of cells where we considered out in atom, outermost orbit cells. In a group. What happens number of cells in a group? So in a group, top to bottom number of cells increases. In a group, top to bottom number of cells increases. What is the reason? Due to electrons enter into the different cells. Due to electrons enter into the different cells. So very important, number of cells in a group increases. What is the reason? The electrons enter into the different cell. Let we take any one group, few examples. First, a group. Any three elements you can say, hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium. Hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium is the first group. Meaning also is there, we consider as any three elements or four elements. Now check it here. Hydrogen atomic number how much? 1. Electronic configuration 1s1. Next, lithium atomic number 3. Electronic configuration 1s2, 2s1. Next, sodium atomic number 11, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Next, potassium 19, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1. So here observe, here what is there, this cell we consider. All cases having same cells are different cells. Here 1s1 is there, here 2s1, here 3s1, 4s1. That means in a group top to bottom, number of cells increases due to electrons enter into the different cells. So this is over. Next, what happens in period, number of cells? B, in a period, in a period from left to right, number of cells is constant. What is the reason? Due to electrons enter into the same cell. In a period number of cells from left to right is constant due to electrons enter into the same cell. Now any one period, how to check it? Second A period, second period, example lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon. This is second period elements. From left to right, what happens? Number of cells we can identify. So here lithium atomic number how much? 3. Electronic configuration 1s2, 2s1. Next, beryllium atomic number 4, 1s2, 2s2. This is electronic configuration. Next, here boron 5, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Carbon 6, 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Nitrogen atomic number 7, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Oxygen atomic number 8, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Next, fluorine atomic number 9, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. Next, neon atomic number 10, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. So here considered ending orbit. So here I have one doubt. So here 2s1, 2s2. So we consider as one orbit. But here, two different orbitals is there, SR12, P orbital. We consider as one orbit. How is possible? But here we consider as orbital number. So if orbital number same is there, we consider as one orbit. This is outermost orbit. This is number of cell. So here also same is their orbital number, that's why we consider as one orbit. Every places we consider as one orbit because of same number of orbital number is there. Now we consider here 2s orbital, 2s orbital, 2s, 2p. That means orbital number same is there, we consider as one orbit. All cases only having 2s, 2p. That means orbital is constant because of the electrons enter into the same orbital. So here also 2s, 2s2, 2s2, 2p1. So this is one orbit. Electrons enter into the same cell. So that's why here number of cells in a period from left to right is constant due to electrons enter into the same cell. So here this is over. Next we consider as valency electrons. What is the meaning of valency electrons? The electrons present in outermost orbit in an atom is called as a valency electrons. The electrons present in outermost orbit in an atom is called as valency electrons. Next, what is the meaning of outermost orbital? The ending orbital in an atom is called as outermost orbit. Next, I will explain. Now, observe some examples. Example 1, nitrogen, atomic number 7, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. So the electrons present in outermost orbital in an atom is called as outermost means ending orbit, ending orbit. So here what is the ending orbit in nitrogen? This is ending, some members consider as 2p3. It is wrong, very very important. If orbital number same is there, we consider as one orbit. That's why it is outermost orbit. Outermost orbit are called as ending orbit. So these electrons present in outermost orbit in an atom is called as valency electrons. Here how many valence electrons is there? 2 plus 3 5. 2 plus 3, total 5 valency electrons. Next, what happens valency electrons in group and period? Now check it. Valency electrons top to bottom in a group is constant. in a group, top to bottom, valency electrons are constant. Let me take any one group examples. First, A group elements. Hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium. Hydrogen atomic number how much? 1. Lithium 3. Sodium 11. Potassium 19. Now write the electronic configuration 1s1. So here any orbital is there, only one is there. That's why it is we consider as one outermost orbit. Here in outermost orbit, how many valence electrons is there? One valency electron. Next, lithium. Electronic configuration 1s2, 2s1. Outermost orbit. The electrons present in outermost orbit in atom is called as valence electrons. Here, how many valence electrons is there? 1. Next, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. So, here in outermost, how many electrons is there? Only 1 electron. Next, potassium also 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1. This is outermost orbit. Here observe ending orbit. 1 electron, 1 electron, 1 electron, 1 electron. So here in a group top to bottom valence electrons are constant. Next, what happens in period? B. In a period, from left to right, valency electrons increases. In a period from left to right, valency electrons increases. Let me take any one period. Second period I have to take. Second period. Elements lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon. So lithium atomic number 3, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s1. Beryllium atomic number 4, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2. Boron atomic number 5, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Carbon atomic number 6, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Next, nitrogen atomic numbers 7, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Oxygen atomic number 8, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Fluorine atomic number 9, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. Neon atomic number 10, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. But we know that what is the definition of valence electrons? The electrons present in outermost orbit. is called as valence electrons. Here how many electrons is there? 1. Here how many valence electrons is there? 2. So here how many is there? This is outermost orbit. 2 plus 1, 3 valency. Here outermost orbit 2s2 2p2 is the outermost orbit. 2 plus 2, 4. Next, here 2s2 2p3 is the outermost orbit. 2 plus 3, 5. 2s2 2p4 is the outermost orbit. 6. 2 plus 4, 6. Here 2s2 2p5. 2 plus 5, 7. Next, 2s2 2p6. 2 plus 8, 2 plus 6, 8. So here what happens? Valency electrons in period increases 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Next we discuss about valency. We know that definition. What is valency? The combining capacity of an element with another element is called as valency. The combining capacity of an element with another element is called as valency. Element. Next, another definition. Gain of electrons is called as valency. Next, another definition. Loss of electrons is called valency. And also here this is the 3 is the definition of valency. The combining capacity of an element with another element, gain of electrons is called as valency, loss of electrons is called as valency. So here the valency depends upon the valency electrons. How it is possible? Now check it. If 1, 2, 3, 4 valency electrons present in valency cell, valency cell means outermost orbit. Cell valency will be one, two, three, four respectively. Suppose example sodium atomic number 11, 1s2 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Here how many valence electrons is there? 1. That's why sodium has 1 valency. So if an atom has 1, 2, 3, 4 valency electrons, then valency will be, we should write 1, 2, 3, 4. Next, another example, magnesium, atomic number 12. Electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. Here how many valence electrons is there? 2. That's why magnesium has 2 valency. Next, aluminium, atomic number 13. Electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p1. So here this is valence shell. How many electrons is there? 3 electrons. 3 valence electrons is there. That's why aluminium valency is 3. Next, silicon atomic number 14, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p2. Here 3s2, 3p2 is the valency shell. How many electrons is there? There are 4 electrons. That's why silicon valency is 4. I said valency depends upon the valency electrons. Here one valence electrons is there, that's why sodium valency 1. Here magnesium 2 valence electrons, that's why valency is 2. Aluminium 3 valence electrons, that's why 3 valency. Silicon 4 valence electrons, that's why valency is 4. Next, if 5, 6, 7 valency electrons present in valency cell, valency will be subtracting 8. So here if 5, 6, 7 valency electrons present in valency cell, valency will be subtracting valency electrons from 8. Now check it. Example nitrogen, atomic number 7, 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. So here what is the outermost orbit? 2s2, 2p3. How many valence electrons is there? 2 plus 3, 5 valency electrons. These 5 valency electrons subtracting from 8, then we get nitrogen valency. So here how many valence electrons is there? 5. So 8 minus 5 equal to 3. So this is the nitrogen valency. Next, another one example. Example 2. Oxygen, atomic number 8, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. How many valence electrons is there in oxygen atom? 6 valence electrons. 2 plus 4 equal to 6 valence electrons. These 6 valence electrons subtracting from 8. So here 8 minus 6 equal to 2. So what is the valence of oxygen? 2. Next, example 3. Fluorine, atomic number 9, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. So here how many valence electrons is there? 7 valence electrons. 2 plus 5, 7 valence electrons. 2 plus 5 equal to 7. Mm-hmm. 8 minus 7 equal to 1. So this is the valency of fluorine. So this is about valency. Next, what happens valency top to bottom in a group from left to right in a period? Thank you. In a group top to bottom, valence is constant. In a group top to bottom, valence is constant because of valence electrons also constant in a group. Now check it. First A group, hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium. Hydrogen atomic number 1, lithium 3, sodium 11, potassium 19. Electronic configuration 1s1, 1s2, 2s1, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Next, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1. Here observe ending orbital electrons is called as valency electrons. Already we discussed previous, if 1, 2, 3, 4 valency electrons present in valency cell, we considered as valency will be 1, 2, 3 like. Here in a group, all elements having only one electron in their valency cell. That's why valence electrons equal to valency. So, but not all, only 1, 2, 3, 4 valence electrons is there, we consider as directly valency will be 1, 2, 3, 4. Here what happens top to bottom valency? Here one valency, here one valency, here one valency, here one valency. Top to bottom in a group valency is constant because of valence electrons also constant. First A group valency 1, second A group valency 2, like that going.